Hi, welcome to mygaytoronto.com. My name is Sean Lieber. In focus, my guest today is international renowned DJ Sydney Blue. Welcome.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
I'm great.
Do you remember your first ever experience and desire to get involved in the music industry?
Yeah, for sure. My first experience was basically when I went to college in Ottawa, and I had just moved from Thunder Bay, Ontario, small town girl, moving to a semi-big city. Ottawa was the next step up, I guess, for me. And it was my first experience going into a nightclub that had house music. And it was a huge experience for me because I got to see a DJ for the first time that played this type of music, which I had never seen before. We didn't have that in Thunder Bay. And it was just really cool to be touched and inspired so much by something. You know, I had never felt anything like that before. And it definitely made me go, okay, this is what I want to do. So I basically lived in Ottawa for 2 years, and I went to college there for those 2 years, and I looked at the DJ. I watched him every Saturday night at this club that I went to all the time, and I was really, really inspired. And then when I had graduated from college, I decided I wanted to come to Toronto. And when I moved here, I ended up buying turntables and starting an actual career of doing it. So it was a bit of a stepping stone for me.
Do you remember your very first gig? How did that go?
Yeah, I do. It was at a place called NASA Dance Pub. It was on Queen Street on the corner of Bathurst and Queen. And it was this little mini dance nightclub that had house music. It was like a little bar. And it was like themed, you know, space themed. They had chairs from airplanes and stuff like that. And it was really cool. It was definitely something I'll never forget. I remember being very nervous. I played there a few times, and I got a big crowd out to come support me. And then they were like, my other people saw me, and they were like, okay, we're gonna book her, you know. And next thing you know, that's how I started getting booked.
And you are the first female electronic music producer to ever have top 10 hits on a Beatport, right?
Yeah.
How does it feel?
I mean, it was crazy. I didn't know it at the time, and then I was told by somebody at Beatport that was the case, like a couple years in. And then I don't know, like, it just, for me, it's always been, you know, a goal of mine to consistently have songs, you know, in the top 10 on Beatport. You know, you couldn't just stop at one. So yeah.
I have to say, during the Pride weekend in Toronto, you are one of the legendary DJs that always packs the stage across the Woody stage. Are we going to be able to see you this year as well?
Unfortunately, I'm not playing Pride this year. I don't know what happened. I guess basically the organizers decided to change everything this year, and I don't really know what their motives were. They just they completely changed all the programming, and I found out in the middle of the winter, and I had been already trying to organize the Friday night, because they said they wanted to do 50 Shades of Blue again this year, and which was the theme that we had last year, and it was so successful and it was so wonderful. And unfortunately, they decided to change things. I was in the middle of planning to get Crystal Waters to perform with me. And I contacted her personally because she's a friend, and she said she was into it. And then when I went to go confirm the gig, I found out that they had changed a bunch of stuff, and they had let some people go, and they didn't want to do 50 Shades of Blue all of a sudden, and they were changing everything. And so I was told to contact a certain person at Pride, because the person that was booking me was let go. And then I ended up contacting them, and they said, sorry, we're just changing things and giving opportunities to other people. It was amazing, the last 2 years. Like, you couldn't get in. Like, there was a lineup down the street, you know, at 8 o'clock at night to get into the stage. And that was definitely a change from what it was when I started. So I felt like we worked really hard to build what it became. And then all of a sudden, these new people came in and just said, sorry. And I'm going to Ibiza in August. I am playing in London, England as well. I'm playing in Croatia. I'm really excited. Yeah, I'm really excited for the summer. And I'm also playing at a lot of great places like Heart Miami, which is like this amazing new club. And then I'm playing at Space in New York City and Detroit and all over, like Chicago and like all these great cities around North America too.
Are you working on a new album?
I am working on a new album right now. Lots of different records are gonna come together for that. But right now I have a record on Tool Room coming out this week actually, which is a big dance music label, and it's on their Ibiza Summer compilation. I'm really excited about that. So that comes out this Friday, this week. Okay, well, yeah, so I basically, when I started my record label, I also started like a little spin-off of all these different things from it, like the radio show, which is Blue Radio, and that happens every 2 weeks. And I have an international guest on every couple weeks. In addition to that, you know, I have the Blue Party, which is, you know, this international show as well, where I bring, you know, international talent in, and we have this big stacked lineup of DJs. So my brand is something I'm really pushing right now. It's the Blue brand, and, you know, it's doing, we had a really successful show in Detroit this past Movement Festival, and we just did the Blue Party here at Sunnyside Pavilion, and it went really well. We're planning some in New York City and Chicago next, as well as a whole bunch of different cities, and we're planning to hopefully bring it to ADE this October, which is in Amsterdam. So I'm really excited about that, and well, I manage it by like being responsible, you know what I mean? I'm not, you know, a young girl that's going nuts anymore, you know, like partying. I'm a businesswoman, you know, and like the way that I see it is I need to be on point as much as possible. I need to be in good health as much as possible. But you know, I'm getting older. I can't like, you know, treat my body badly. So I have to stay in shape. I do a lot of yoga. I spend a lot of quality time with my dog. I love going out because I need to go out to just hear other music, you know what I mean? Like Movement in Detroit, I made a point of going to the festival the whole weekend, even though I only had one show there. You know, I love going to Electric Island. I have to pick and choose. I can't go out if I have a night off in Toronto, I'm not necessarily gonna go to a nightclub. I'd probably take it off, you know, stay in. But then at the point, if a DJ friend comes into town or like, you know, there's a really special event happening, like Electric Island, which I love, you know, or something, I make a point to go to it because I think it's important. I need to stay in touch with what's going on.
Without going too personal, how difficult is it to maintain a relationship? Is there any relationship possible with the job that you...
Yeah, it is. It's definitely possible. But I think that whoever I'm meant to be with is probably somebody who... is a special, unique person too, because I just, I definitely need somebody who understands what I do more than just, you know, I don't want to have to explain it too much.
Well, I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Have an amazing time and nice travels, and thank you so much for
Thank you so much.
Thank you, babe.
Awesome. It was wonderful.